Throwaway time. What's your secret that could literally ruin your life if it came out?
Deleted. My boyfriend and I met at the brothel where I used to work. As a whore. Deleted. Removed. I've never stayed on a thread this long. No matter how late to the party you are, your story will have readers. Removed. I accidentally killed 7 people. I put a rag into a new water heater exhaust to keep debris out and installed it in a rental. I get a call a week later, there's been an accident. I show up and there's a ton of EMS and police. They ask me where the gas shut off is, and I go down to shut the gas off and see the end of the rag I forgot sticking out of the top of the heater. Ripped the rag out, shut the gas off and head upstairs only to be told. All the tenants were dead. I drink all day now and sleep. It's killing me from the inside every single day, but if I say anything my family is ruined, we have a bunch of rental properties and we'd be shut down. When I was 17 I had an argument with my father and told him to fuck off, later that evening he hung himself. Our argument was the last time he spoke to anyone in our family and for that I feel a terrible amount of guilt for. Instead of him saying goodbye and I love you to my mom and brothers, he got told to fuck off before he went and killed himself. My punishment is to live the rest of my days in shame and guilt. He never left a note either. I know this thread is most likely dead now, but I used to masturbate a lot. And when I was 10 I had a technique where I'd let off a load into a sock then wash it and quickly dry it. Now I couldn't leave it hanging outside or use a dryer otherwise my family would have seen it and probably smell it or whatnot. So I'd put it inside my gas heater unit. Unfortunately my sock had caught on fire inside the unit, blew it up and set my house on fire. Only my brother was home at the time, and he managed to survive, the house did not. For 5 years we stayed from caravan park to caravan park whilst we waited for confirmation that it was not arson and we could receive an insurance payout. We eventually did and scraped together money to start rebuilding the house. The house is still being rebuilt to this day and it shames me anytime I have to visit my parents living in a tiny mobile home where my backyard once was. My grade 6 teacher let me touch her boobs once. Honestly, I've kinda been waiting for a thread like this to come up. None of my friends know any of this, and I don't want to tell them. Not so much a lack of trust as their inability to understand. So, when I was in middle high school, my mom, sister, and I were living with my stepfather, better school district from where I was. Everything was fine for a few years, but he got crazy. Whenever my mom left for work, my sister and I were left alone with him until he left. He worked second shift. First he'd start with yelling at us for no good reason. A reason, yes, but never a good one, it was always insignificant. Needless to say, my sis and I were scared shitless when this happened. Things escalated from there. He'd start hitting us, almost every day. Again, always over something insignificant. A good example was when I hung one of his shirts with the hanger hook facing left instead of right. It got to a point several times where he'd actually grab whichever one of us happened to be in his way and hold us off the ground, against the wall, by the throat. To make it clear, my mother knew about none of this. The man knew how to hit you so it didn't leave a mark, and he is an obscenely good liar. Anytime we tried to call him out to her, he'd lie his way around it. The only time that other side came out around her, he blamed it on his heart medicine. My sister moved out when she turned 18, but I still had 3 years left. So now all of his anger was directed at me. One time in my senior year, I was actually scared for my life and ran off into the woods next to the house until my mom got home. She finally believed me then, and we made plans to leave as soon as I graduated. She told him she wanted to leave, and he of course decided that I was costing him his marriage. Those last few months were hell, but in June of last year we moved. I'm now in college, safely away from him. While I bear no malice against him, I will not forgive the shit he put me through. Also, it feels wonderful to finally get this off my chest and tell it to someone, even if nobody reads this. Yesterday I thought I had problems. Today my life is grand. buried comment, but here goes. Not life ruining, but makes me feel like shit every time I think about it. As I've told Reddit before, I have a blind brother. When we were young, I used to get so frustrated at all the extra attention he received and how I had to be more responsible with my sibling than my peers. So, when my brother and I would go play, go to the store, or just generally go anywhere without adults, I would abandon him somewhere unfamiliar to him. Then, I would stand off quietly and watch the anxiety set in as he tried to figure out where he was and what was going on. Also, I was really intelligent as a child and knew that was my ticket to attention. When I would help my brother with his homework, I would teach him all the wrong answers, so that I could continue being the smarter sibling. Today, my brother is my best friend. He goes to college and lives by himself. He's become one of the most intelligent men I've ever met. I'm trying to make it up to him now by being the best big sister ever, but I still feel so guilty at how I found him to be a burden when I was a kid. Edit, update. I immediately called my brother after posting this and caught him while he was walking to a study group. I told him about my guilt and he laughed. He understands how frustrating it must have been. He told me that all of the good things I have done as a sister completely overshadow anything bad I did and that he loves me more than anything. I'm glad I spoke with him and I encourage others on here to talk to someone if they can. My daughter turns 5 next week. If anyone knew the truth behind her parentage, I could probably lose her forever. I grew up in foster care, never knew my parents or siblings. In my senior year, I met an older guy and we dated for almost a year. Getting pregnant about 7 months in. One night while we were watching TV, the subject somehow came around to our real parents. He had been adopted as a young child. Turns out the man I was seeing, the father of my daughter, is my half-brother. We have the same mother. Our relationship didn't last, and he is not in her life, per his own choices. My daughter is extremely smart, beautiful, and well-rounded. She'll never know the truth. Her father and I made a pact to never tell her. I just hope she never needs a kidney or something. Edit, keep reading about people who knowingly slept with relatives they grew up with. Is it bad that I feel slightly less horrible? After graduating from high school, I went to a small out-of-state college where no one from high school knew me. I was told many times how impressive my false Australian accent was, so I decided it would be great fun to go through college pretending to be from Australia. All of my friends and even my girlfriend of 2 years think I'm Australian. I have a completely fake Australian identity, family, and past. I will soon be graduating, and I plan on asking the girl to marry me. Everything she knows about me is Australian. I don't know how to tell her she doesn't really know me. Guess I'm forever a bloke. Removed. My son attempted suicide and now he's pissed at me because I'm making him see a shrink. This post makes me think I'm doing the right thing. So thanks. Had serious depression my whole life. 3 minor suicide attempts, countless other thoughts of just stepping on the gas pedal and slamming into a wall. Lost my job a couple years back and hit an all-time low. Took a shitty job at a grocery store. Found out my wife was pregnant and thought the best thing for her and the baby would be for me to not be around anymore. On my last day I plan to live, my wife tells me our baby is the size of a sweet pea. I smile and act happy knowing I will never see that sweet pea. Go to work in the morning and near the end of my shift I'm standing in the frozen department and am near tears. Close my eyes and ask myself what's the point, time to end this. Then I hear someone yell my wife's name aloud. Twice. I look over and see a lady who happens to have my wife's name. Okay. Just a coincidence. Then I look down and see her holding a box of sweet peas. I start crying and go home. Tell me everything. Got the help I need. The sweet pea is 2 now and has a sister on the way. I live my life for them. They saved me. Just remember that no matter how bad it gets, there are people out there who love you and want to help. Don't be afraid to ask. Be strong, Reddit, and stay alive for the ones that love you.